Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the square wave voltage, explain the growth and the decay of the current in an RLC series circuit fed by a square voltage, and explain the effect of the inductance and the resistance of the circuit on the current growth and decay.
Square wave voltage. Look at the closed series circuit. We have a closed switch, we have a lamp, and a function generator which provides a square wave voltage at a frequency of 250 Hz and at an amplitude of 9 volts. The second figure is the graph that represents UG as a function of time. Now I will turn on the simulation so that you can observe the graph of UG versus time. Observe. Now I will pause the simulation. Okay, pause. Now, let's analyze the graph. First remark or first note is that the voltage is periodic because it repeats itself identically during a constant time interval, which is equal to 4 milliseconds as shown in the figure. Now, this constant time interval is the period of the voltage. The voltage is periodic, so it has a period. Now, the period of the voltage is equal to 1 over the frequency. The frequency of the generator is 250 Hz, so 1 over 250 Hz is 0.004 seconds, which is equal to 4 milliseconds. So this is the period. Now, what happens during each period? Now, in the figure, during the first half period, the voltage is maximum. So it is equal to the amplitude of the function generator, which is equal to 9 volts. In the second half period, as you see, the voltage is zero. This is the square wave voltage.
The figure shows a square wave voltage on the screen of the oscilloscope, so that during the first half of each period, the voltage is equal to a constant value E, and during the second half of each period, the voltage is equal to zero. E is given by this formula. E is equal to SV times Y, where SV is the vertical sensitivity or the amplitude gain of the oscilloscope, and Y is the number of the vertical divisions measured relative to the time axis. The period of the voltage is given by this formula, T is equal to VB times X, where VB is the horizontal sensitivity or the time base of the oscilloscope, and X is the number of the horizontal divisions measured over one cycle.
In this experiment, we want to observe the growth and the decay of the current in an RL series circuit fed by a square wave voltage. Let's explain our experiment. So here we have a resistor of resistance 1 kilo ohms connected in series across a coil whose inductance is 100 millihenry. Now, the resistor and the coil are connected in series with the function generator. As you see, the function generator is adjusted to provide a square wave voltage. Now, we want to observe the growth and the decay of the current on the screen of the oscilloscope. You know that the curve of the current is similar to that of the voltage across the resistor. They only differ by a constant multiplying factor. So we will connect the oscilloscope across the resistor. Observe. Now, this is the growth process of the current. At the end of the growth process, the current becomes constant. We say that steady state is attained. And this is the decay process. And at the end of the decay process, the current becomes zero and we say that steady state is attained. Now, how can we explain this phenomenon?
Now, let's explain the growth and the decay of the current that observed in the previous experiment. Consider this circuit. The square wave voltage delivered by G has a maximum value E equal 4 volt and a period T equal 5 millisecond. Remark, the oscilloscope does not display a current. It displays only a voltage. So that we insert a resistor in series with the coil, and then the coil and the resistor are connected across G. In the next slide, we will explain how does the voltage across R represent the current in the coil. The ground of the oscilloscope is connected to point C, and the phase of channel 1 is connected to point A, so Y1 or channel 1 displays the voltage UAC equal UG across the generator. And the phase of channel 2 is connected to point B, so channel 2 or Y2 displays the voltage UBC equal UR across the resistor.
Focus please, this is important.
As we have seen in the previous slide, UBC is the voltage across the resistor and UAC is the voltage across the generator. The voltage provided by the function generator is a square wave voltage, so it is maximum during the first half period and zero during the second half period. Now we want to study the variation of the current on the screen of the oscilloscope, but the curves on the screen of the oscilloscope represent voltage and we want to study current. How can we do this? The voltage across a resistor is equal to its resistance multiplied by the current it carries. And R is a positive constant because we have an ideal resistor. This means that I is directly proportional to UR. Therefore, the curve of UR is similar to that of I, differing only by a constant multiplying factor. So now we can use the curve of UR on the screen of the oscilloscope to study the variation of the current. So, during the first half period, the voltage across the resistor increases. So, the current increases and this is the growth process. During the second half period, the voltage across the resistor decreases. So, the current decreases and this is the decay process. Let me remind you with the steady state. At the end of the growth process, the current becomes maximum. We say that steady state is attained. And also, at the end of the decay process, the current becomes zero. So this is the steady state. In the steady state, the current becomes constant. It does not vary anymore. Now, let's use the curves to explain the phenomenon. When the current in the coil changes, the coil is crossed by a variable self-flux. Then the coil becomes the seat of self-induced electromotive force. Now, according to Lenz's law, this electromotive force tends to oppose the change in this current. So, it delays its growth and delays its decay. As you see in the figure, the current does not reach its maximum value instantly. We have a delay in the growth. Similarly, in the decay process, the current does not reach its minimum value, which is zero, instantly. We have a delay in the decay.
Effect of the inductance and the resistance of the RL series circuit on current growth and decay. To study this effect, we use two experimental simulations. The first simulation studies the effect of the inductance of the coil on the growth and the decay of the current. Consider the first circuit. This circuit includes a function generator which provides a square wave voltage of frequency 500 Hz, a resistor of resistance 80 Ohm. In this simulation, 20 Ohm represents the internal resistance of the coil and 10 mH represents the inductance of the coil. The graph shows the voltage across the generator and the resistor as functions of time. Let's start the simulation. We notice that the steady state is attained at T equals 0.5 millisecond, and the maximum value of UR is 8 volt. That means the maximum value of the current is given by UR maximum over R. UR maximum equal 8 volt and R equal 80 ohm. Then I maximum is equal 8 over 80, which is equal to 0.1 ampere. Now consider the second circuit. The circuit is identical to the first circuit, except of the inductance of the coil. In this circuit, L is equal 16 millihenry, greater than that in the first circuit. I will repeat the simulation, but now the graph will show the voltage across R in the two circuits simultaneously. The blue curve represents UR in the first circuit, where L is equal 10 millihenry, and the green curve represents UR in the second circuit, where L is equal to 16 millihenry. We notice that in the second circuit, corresponding to the green curve, the steady state is attained at T equals 0.8 millisecond, and the maximum value of UR remains 8 volt. So that the maximum value of the current also remains 0.1 ampere as that in the first circuit. So we can conclude that when the inductance of the coil increases, the time needed to reach the steady state increases, and this inductance does not affect the maximum value of the current. Now, the second experimental simulation studies the effect of R on the growth and the decay of the current. The first circuit is identical to that in the previous simulation, so that the steady state corresponding to this circuit is attained at T equals 0.5 millisecond, and the maximum value of the current in this circuit is I equals 0.1 ampere. Consider the third circuit. The circuit is identical to the first circuit, except the resistance of the resistor. In this circuit, the resistance of the resistor is equal to 50 ohm, which is less than that in the first circuit. The graph will show the voltage across R in the two circuits simultaneously. Let's start the simulation. The blue curve represents the voltage across R in the first circuit, where R equals 80 ohm, and the dark red curve represents the voltage across R in the second circuit, where R is equal to 50 ohm. We notice that in the second circuit, corresponding to the dark red curve, the steady state is attained at T equal 0.7 millisecond, and the maximum value of the voltage is equal to 7 volt. So the maximum value of the current is given by 7 over 50, which is equal to 0.14 ampere, which is greater than that in the first circuit. So we can conclude that when the resistance of the RL series circuit decreases, the time needed to reach the steady state increases and the maximum value of the current increases. Conclusion: when the inductance of the coil increases and the resistance of the series RL circuit decreases, the growth and the decay process becomes slower. The maximum value of the current attained in the steady state is not affected by the value of the inductance, but it increases with the decrease in the resistance of the circuit. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.